हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल पावर ऑफ नॉलेज। सो गाइस, टुडे लेट्स सी अबाउट द एयरलाइन लैंग्वेज एंड द कोड विच वी यूज ऑफ्टन इन आवर डेली ऑपरेशंस और डेली वर्क टाइम एंड व्हाट एंड ऑल द यूजर्स आर ऑफ दोज थिंग्स। सो गाइस, आई होप द प्रीवियस वीडियोज वेयर गुड बिकॉज आई डिडंट गेट एनी कमेंट। सो होपफुली आई एम थिंकिंग दैट इट इज़ गुड and whoever is watching, I think they are liking it. So let's begin with the video. So friends, let's start with the phonetic alphabet today. So guys, let me tell you why phonetic alphabets are used or what are the uses of these phonetic alphabets. So as you all know guys, every profession has its own language or jargon which can sound very confusing to the other who is listening. Suppose if you are on call or if you are on phone, you are trying to convey a message to some of the staff, there is a chances of miscommunication. Like if you are saying we, that means normally we can in our phonetic alphabet we call it as Victor. So suppose on call if you are saying V, but the person who is listening to you, he can take it as B. So there is no much difference between V and B. The same way there is no much difference between F and S, right? Like there can be a signal error. Also it can be like in India all the state or like all our which and all states we have, all the states has their own languages, right? So here the pronunciation of alphabet also varies from one person to other person. So there is a chances of like he is saying something and we are taking it as something else. So that is why alphabet phonetic alphabet came into the aviation field. And it is a ICAO suggested phonetic alphabets. So it's not like it's only used in India, it is used in all over the world in the aviation field. Even if there is a conversation between pilot and a ATC or air traffic controller, those conversation also happens in phonetic alphabets. So as you can see in the back screen, there are lots of there is a table in which we have all the alphabets, like A stands for Alpha, B stands for Bravo, C stands for Charlie, D for Delta, E for Echo, F for Foxtrot, so on. So guys, have a look on these all alphabets and try to bahat it out. Okay, I can give you one more example. Like suppose if we are speaking on walkie-talkie, like usually in airports we also use walkie-talkie. So while speaking in walkie-talkie, there is a chances of the other person taking your word in, like if you are saying B, he is taking as V. So there is a chances like these kind of miscommunications can happen, and because of this kind of miscommunication there can be a chances of any incidents, or there is a chances like any safety lapse can happen, right? So these kind of things should not happen. So ICAO had recommended these phonetic alphabets. Okay guys, so please have a look every day, try to practice. It's not that difficult, it is very easy. You can practice and you can learn. So please go ahead. I'll just pronunciate it once. So till F we are done. F for Foxtrot, G for Golf, H for Hotel, I for India, J for Juliet, K for Kilo, L for Lima, M for Mike, N for November, O for Oscar, P for Papa, Q for Cubic, R for Romeo, S for Sierra, T for Tango, U for Umbrella, V for Victor, W for Whiskey, X for X-ray, Y for Yankee and Z for Zulu. So these are the alphabetic phonetics. So guys, I'll not say you can learn it in 1 or 2 days, but if you practice within 3 to 4 days, you can catch up this. Okay, now let's see the next codes. So in our field we also use often a shortcut codes which are being used from long back, and all the airlines uses these codes to communicate easily. So some abbreviative list below will be spoken. Like below means the back screen, I'll show you. So these are the codes which we often use it. So you can see we call it as communication code, and the first one is A/C. So in general, A/C means people think it out as like AC, but here in aviation A/C we take it as aircraft. Okay, same way AOG, the short form of aircraft on ground is AOG. So AOG means aircraft on ground. Same way we have few 3-letter and four letters communication codes. Go through once, it's not that difficult. If you just read it once, you will get to know what it is. Just I will tell you 3 to 4 communication codes which are new, or like it can be new for you guys. So one you can see is like UFIDS, UFIDS. So the full form of UFIDS is Flight Information Display System. Okay, so generally this is the TV which you can see in the airports or in the terminal, on which the flight flight timings, arrival, departure timings will be shown. So that display system we call it as UFIDS in the short form. The full form is Flight Information Display System. Okay, then we have MAS, MAAS, that means Meet and Assist Service. So usually Meet and Assist Service are given to handicap, or like a people need assistance, or like a person traveling for the first time, he doesn't know much about the airport, those kind of things, they need meet and assist service. And also like physically challenged, it can be blind, deaf, those kind of passengers, they require meet and assist service. So for that we call it as MAS, MAAS. Then we have UNMR. So the full form of UNMR is unaccompanied minor. So basically if any passenger whose age is between 5 to 12 years, so if the age of the passenger is 5 to 12 years, and if he or she is traveling alone in a flight, so those passengers we call it as UNMR. So the full form of UNMR is unaccompanied minor. So what and all procedures are we have to follow for UNMR, we will go deeply in our course and we'll check it out. The same way we have LDM. The full form of LDM is Load Distribution Manifest. So the LDM part you can see over here in the white screen. This is the load distribution message of an aircraft, incoming aircraft. So how many passengers are there, how many baggages, how many cargo, so what and all it contains, everything will be there in this short message which we call it as LDM. So friends, only this much for today. We'll meet up in the next video with a new topic of airport codes. So that is also a very important topic. So we'll check it out in the next upcoming video. And guys, today's video notes, like what and all alphabetic phonetics alphabets and what and all codes we have, that notes I have prepared and I have given the link in the description. So you guys can go there and download it. And guys, still I'll stick to my words that if you feel that my way of teaching is not that good, or if you guys want me to change the way of teaching, you guys can comment. I will accept it and I'll try to change it. Okay, so only this much for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I have one more request, that please subscribe to my channel, and if you like the video, please press the like button. So we'll meet up in next class. Till then, bye bye, take care.